Hey, and just like that, almost another year has passed and we've arrived at Home Assistant version 2025.12. This December release has something truly fantastic, namely Labs. But there's more and I'm going to show it all to you in this video. Let's dive in. Every month it remains exciting to see what new components have been added to Home Assistant and what has been changed. I have installed the beta and have already been able to play with all the news that will be released on the first Wednesday of December. And I generally think it's fantastic. Let's quickly go to Home Assistant to see what's new. Let's go to Labs first. System. Labs. Labs is something that you can compare to beta, but it's not beta. It's actually functionalities that you can turn on or turn off temporarily to test them and to give feedback to Home Assistant. And they already added two things there. One is a funny thing, that's winter mode, so let's just enable it. I'm not going to make an automatic backup because that's takes a lot of time. So if I enabled it, you get this great snowflakes on your screen. So, but this is of course only for the fun of it. Let's disable it again. But the big thing about this is automations, intuitive triggers and conditions. It will probably get another name. So let's enable this. And now let's go to automations to see what this does. Settings, automations. Let's create a new automation. So this looks still the same as how it always looked, but when I click add trigger now, I have a new option here. I can select between targets and triggers. So if I choose for triggers, I get my old triggers that I already had. And when you go to targets, this is something totally new. Now you can target, for instance, a whole floor. So I can click on ground floor and then you see all kinds of triggers here. For instance, when a climate is turned off, when a climate is turned on, and this counts for the whole floor. But I can also go to a specific room, for instance, let's say the office. If I click on the office, then you get when a climate is turned off only for the office, or a climate is turned on in the office. And if I click this, I can also change things like the behavior of the target climates to trigger on. So if only the first climate is turned on, or the last, or if any climate is turned on. So this is a big thing. Let's delete this, add another trigger. Again, I go to ground floor and I can go down this way. So I can go to office and I can also say, okay, I want a specific, let's see, a specific light. Let's say the office back left light. When the light is turned off, office back left. So this is immediately working. The only thing is, this is in test, so not all triggers are there yet. There are no triggers yet, for instance, for if a motion sensor detected motion. So if I go to add trigger, I still can do that. I mean, I cannot find it here, even not in, if I go to, let's say, unassigned entities, and if I go to binary sensors and I have a bathroom motion sensor, you see there are no triggers available yet, but this will be added in the future. But you can do it, of course, still using the old method. If you go to triggers and then search for let's say state, let's say office motion sensor, it's going to detect it, then you can still work with this. So that's still working. This same mechanism also works for conditions. So you have in conditions also targets, conditions and blocks. Okay, and in actions you have the same. So you can target, let's say, all the lights in my office, say ground floor, office, trigger automation, let's say button, camera, climate, cover lights. So turn off, let's say I want to turn off all the lights in my office. So light turn off on office, and then it turns off all my lights. You can see it's 53 entities in my office of lights that I have here. So this is really a big thing. Now we are getting into a user interface that's getting more and more user friendly. So I'm really excited about this, and I'm curious what you think about it. Let me know in the comments. Then there has been changes made to dashboards. Let's go to dashboards. That's the settings, dashboards. What you now can do is you can set a standard dashboard for your whole system. So now, as you can see, now my overview is the default dashboard, and I want to change it. And I have here my built-in dashboards, and I have the user-created dashboards. So I'm going to tablet. I want to make it my default dashboard. Set as default. Okay. And now tablet is the default dashboard for my whole system. You can still change this for each user. If you go to the user and you scroll down, you see here dashboards, and I can still change the dashboard, or I can use the auto use system settings dashboard. That's one thing in the dashboards. Another thing is that we can now change our areas, labels and zones. For instance, if I have the ground floor and I think my office is more important, so I can now drag and drop it to the second position. And if I go to the automated home dashboard, you will see that the office is now on the second position. If I go back, and if I go to areas, labels and zones, and I'm going to say hallway is the third position, and I go back to home, you see that hallway is now in the third position. Speaking of which, there's now a new sidebar here that shows things that might be interesting to you. So that is also added in the automated home dashboard. For people who didn't know that there is an automated home dashboard, it was already there for quite some time, but it was still experimental, and now it's not experimental anymore. So it is here automatically, and it is standard, not visible. So this is the home dashboard. It's standard, not visible. So if you want to show it, just long click on your Home Assistant logo, and then you can make it visible here. Oh, I made it not visible anymore. So make it visible and save. And there it is. Okay. Then the next thing is the energy dashboard. We now have an energy dashboard that is divided in an overview page. This is the overview page. And you can go down to, for instance, electricity, and then you get the electricity page. And there's much more shown now, because now you have the current power flow in your overview and in the detail page. And you also can see the specific electricity usage, the current electricity usage, I must say. So that is also really nice. And to make that work, you have to go to the energy configuration. And for instance, for each individual device, you have to select a power consumption statistic. So that is new. So, and also that counts also for your solar panels, solar power. It counts for your battery. Battery power in this case, etc. Next to that, you can also now add individual water devices. I do not have them in my house, but if you have them, you can measure the specific water usage for instance, your washing machine. Also, great thing. So these were the new main things that have been added in Home Assistant 2025.12. Of course, there are also new integrations, and there's a lot this time. So if you have one of these integrations, let's see what's in there. Home Assistant Labs, Philips Hue BLE, Victron BLE, Google Air Quality, and there are also improvements to existing integrations, and that's also a lot. Of course, the RioLink integrations got some new love, and there are much more things here. So go through this list. I will put the link in the description. And of course, next to the integrations, new integrations, there are some integrations that we are saying farewell to. And one of them is Domino's Pizza. It turned out that nobody is using Home Assistant to order pizzas. So this one is gone. And there are some other things that are gone now in Home Assistant. Furthermore, you have other noteworthy changes. Let's see what's in there. You can delete helpers directly from the helpers panel. That's nice. Let's see how that works. Settings, go to helpers, helpers, select an helper. And now there is a delete option here, which wasn't there before. You can also add entities to Android widgets and favorites. I don't use Android, so I cannot show that to you, but there is a video here that shows that if you click on an option add to, you can select add to Android auto favorites, add to Pixel watch favorites. So maybe that's something for you. It's not for me. And there's also backward incompatible changes, of course. So these were the changes you can expect in Home Assistant 2025.12. Pay close attention to reading the breaking changes before you install this version so you won't face any surprises. Thank you for watching, and I want to especially thank these people because they sponsor me monthly so I can keep doing this work. Do you also find my videos valuable and want to see more videos like this? Then sponsor me too. You can do that via Patreon, Ko-fi, or by becoming a paid member of this channel. You can find the links in the description of this video. Thanks again, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you again soon. Bye bye!